हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू टू आवर केमिस्ट्री साइंस एंड टुडे आई एम बैक विद अ न्यू वीडियो दैट इज दी व्हाट इज नवामसा चार्ट। ऑल दी इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स रिगार्डिंग द नवामसा चार्ट वी विल डिस्कस टुडे इन डिटेल्स, सो स्टे टिल द एंड एंड गेट टू नो रिगार्डिंग ईच एंड एवरी इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स रिगार्डिंग द D9 नवामसा चार्ट। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। द सक्सेस ऑफ वैदिक एस्ट्रोलॉजी मच डिपेंड्स अपॉन द डिविजनल चार्ट्स। इन फैक्ट द हॉरोस्कोप और द लग्न चार्ट विच वी डिस्कस which we analyze and judge itself is a divisional chart, which we also call as D1 chart. But apart from the D1 Lagna chart, the most important divisional chart is the D9 chart, which we also called Navamsa chart. The Navamsa chart is basically the soul of the horoscope. If Lagna chart is the body, then the soul lies in the Navamsa chart. The basis of our life means why we are here, the purpose, the basic foundation of life, what our soul actually wants from us, that can be understood from the D9 Navamsa chart. When we talk about the Lagna chart, it is basically that what world see that we do or we feel or we behave or what we like in front of the world, that is the Lagna chart. Let us take one example. For example, your child may be very good in education, may be doing a very good job, earning in millions. But it may happen that when he comes home back from work, very often he talks about his hobbies. It may happen that he may say that I could have been a very good music director, or I could have been a very good painter, or my likings lies to be a athlete, to be an athlete. Or it may happen that after 5 years or 10 years later, he may take of what he loves actually, what his soul actually loves, he may start doing that. So that can be understood that what the soul actually wants from you, that can be understood from the D9, because the D1 was actually focusing that what he is doing now, or what his education was, or what he is earning. That can be understood from the D1, that world, what world is feeling, because the world may feel that, oh, he is really successful, he was very good at studies, he was doing a very good job and he was earning in millions, oh my god, he was having a very good life. But suddenly, I don't know what happened, he left everything and he started painting. But when you ask that guy, he will say, I am much more happy now. I cannot express my happiness when I paint, because that was the important factor which the soul was wanting. So you can say that that strategy of life which has changed suddenly and gone into a different direction, that can be understood from the D9, because something, the purpose of life was hidden in the D9 chart, which was not visible in the D1 chart. So when we analyze the horoscope of any individual, it is very essential to judge and make analysis of both D1 and D9 simultaneously. Because if you are only judging the D1 chart, trust me, there will be a very big loophole. You won't be able to understand that what is the correct meaning of life. And this may lead to some little knowledge, because little knowledge is really dangerous. So D9 chart can be, should be actually. In fact, I say must be analyzed as par with the D1 chart. Now let us understand that how can we actually make the D9 chart? What is the important factors regarding that? Let us talk about that. Every sign, now we have 12 signs. Every sign comprises of 30 degree. If we break the sign, that 30 degree, into 9 equal divisions, we get an equivalent division of 3 degree 20 minutes. Because since we are talking about the D9 chart, Navamsa chart means 9 equal divisions. When we translate in English, it means 9 equal divisions. We get 3 degree 20 minutes. That is the comprisement of one Navamsa. Interestingly, a nakshatra consists of 4 pada or 4 quarters. Each quarter consists of 3 degree 20 minutes. depending upon the placement of a planet in a sign and the characteristics of the sign, the placement of the planet in the D9 chart can be calculated mathematically. For example, let us take the example of Jupiter. Now suppose Jupiter is at 11 degree in the sign of Aries. Now let us calculate what will be the position of Jupiter in the D9 chart. First factor, placement of the planet. Second factor, characteristics of the sign. Placement is at 11 degree. The first Lavamsa will be of 3 degree 20 minutes, means from 0 degree to 3 degree 20 minutes. The second Lavamsa will be from 3 degree 20 minutes to 6 degree 40 minutes. Similarly, the third Navamsa will be from 6 degree 40 minutes to 10 degree, and the fourth Navamsa will be from 10 degree onwards and it will end at 13 degree 20 minutes. And since Jupiter is at 11 degree, that means we can say that it is in the fourth Navamsa in the sign of Aries. Now we will take into account the characteristics of the sign. We will divide into three parts, that is the movable, fixed and dual signs. If it is a movable sign, that is 1, 4, 7, 10, means Aries, Cancer, Libra and Capricorn. If it is a movable sign, the counting starts from the sign itself. That means in which sign the placement will be in the Navamsa chart, that counting will start from the sign itself if it is a movable sign. Now since Jupiter was in the sign of Aries, we will count from the sign of Aries itself. It was in the fourth Navamsa, so let us count. First is Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, that is in the fourth house in the natural zodiac. Now I am not talking about the Navamsa Lagna, I am just talking about the position of Jupiter. In the D1 chart, Jupiter was in the sign of Aries. But in the D9 chart, Jupiter got placed in the sign of Cancer and got exalted in the sign of Cancer. Now, let us analyze it. Let us take this an example and analyze it. In the D1 chart, Jupiter was in the sign of Aries. Now, the Lord of Aries is Mars. Mars and Jupiter are friends. And Aries itself is a fiery sign. So Jupiter was in a very good dignity in the sign of Aries. But in the D9 Navamsa chart, the placement of Jupiter got far more better because Jupiter got exalted in the sign of Cancer. So you can say the dignity of the planets got improved. That means you can say the true dignity of any planet can be understood from the D9 Navamsa chart. So it is very interesting to understand that with the help of D1 chart, D9 chart can be made, and both D1 and D9 should be analyzed and judged simultaneously in a very deep manner. Then only the judgment of the horoscope can be given, because the dignity of the planets are very important here. So I talked about the movable signs. Now I will talk about the fixed signs, that is the 2, 5, 8, 11, that is Taurus, Leo, Scorpio and Aquarius. In case of the fixed signs, the counting starts from the 9 places away from it. Now suppose the planet Venus is in the sign of Taurus. It is a fixed sign. So the counting will start 9 places away from Taurus. So the 9th sign away from Taurus is Capricorn. So the counting will start from Capricorn. Now suppose Venus is at 5 degree. 0 to 3 degree 20 minutes, first Navamsa. 3 degree 20 minutes to 6 degree 40 minutes, second Navamsa. Since it is in the 5 degree, so it comes in the second Navamsa. That means two houses from Capricorn. So Capricorn is the first house, Aquarius is the second house. So the placement of Venus will be in the sign of Aquarius in the D9 chart. So in the D1 chart it was in Taurus, in the D9 chart it got into the placement of Aquarius. This was the analysis and the transfer of the planets when it is in the fixed signs. Now let us discuss regarding the last dual signs, that is 3, 6, 9, 12, Gemini, Virgo, Sagittarius and Pisces. Now let us take one example here. Suppose a planet sits in the sign of Sagittarius, that is the 9. 3, 6, 9, 12, 9 is the Sagittarius. In case of dual signs, the counting starts from 5 places away from it. That means 5 places away from 9 is 1, that is Aries. Now the counting will start from Aries. Now suppose Sun sits in the sign of Sagittarius in 12 degree, suppose. So it is in the 4th Navamsa. So when we count 4th place from Aries, because Aries is the 5th sign away from Sagittarius, and 4 places from Aries is Cancer. So Cancer in D9 you will find Sun is sitting over there. So here we can understand that how the placement of planets or the dignity of the planets changes from D1 to D9. It is very important to understand the dignity of the true dignity of the planets. It may happen that a planet gets exalted in D1. We can become very happy. Oh my God, I have two exalted planets in my D1 chart. I will become a king. But when we analyze the D9 chart, we may find that one of the planets gets debilitated in the D9 chart. So it is losing the dignity. It may feel that it is exalted in the D1 chart, but it is losing the dignity and it gets debilitated in the D9 chart. So what happens? It is unable to give the best result which we actually expect that an exalted planet should give. When we go into the operation of the horoscope, we get to find, oh my God, the planet is actually debilitated in the D9 chart. The sole purpose of the horoscope in that D9 chart, the planets is not in a very good dignity. That is the reason it is unable to give the best result. And at the same time, suppose a planet is in its debility in the D1 chart but gets exalted in the D9 chart. So we may feel the planet is not in a very good dignity in D1 chart, and we expect normally that the planet will not give the best result. But sometimes what happens, it becomes opposite. We are actually getting the best result. So when we check the D9 chart, we see, oh, it is actually exalted here. That is the reason it is giving the best result. So the true dignity can be understood only by the D9 chart, not by the D1 chart. D1 chart can show a basic mirror, a basic focus, that what the world can see from us, what we are doing, the body. But what actually the soul actually wants, that can be understood from the D9 chart. Let me take one example. Suppose Sun is at 21 degree in the sign of Libra. When we check the actual D9 of that placement of the Sun, we will find the Sun will be in the sign of Aries in the D9 chart. Now see, when Sun is in Libra, Sun gets debilitated. But when Sun comes to Aries, it gets exalted. Since Sun is in the 21 degrees of Libra, it comes in the 7th Navamsa. So 7th house from Libra is the Aries. In the sign of Aries, Sun gets exalted. That means now the Sun, when the time period of Sun will come, Sun will actually give a good result. It will not give the result of debilitation. Rather, it may give a very good result, because actually the dignity of the planet has improved. So like this, we have to understand that how the dignity of the planets works. Most important fact now I will discuss regarding the Navamsa chart, that why we actually study Navamsa chart. Navamsa chart normally deals with many things. Basically, some say that this chart is the chart of fortune, because when we divide the sign by 9, 9th house is actually the house of fortune. Because what our soul actually wants, if we come to know regarding that, we can become king. Because the journey of the soul is infinite. It has traveled many years, traveling from one body to another body, in order to find the destination, in order to find the purpose of life. It is very easy to understand and very difficult at the same time that we are a spiritual being, we are using this human body. Many of us may feel that we are a human body and we are trying to become spiritual, but try to think in a different way. The soul is using this human body. The soul has used many human body in the past birth also, and it will also use the human body in the future births also. So it is just a station where we are waiting for the friend to come. So we are actually the spiritual being using this human body in order to accomplish the purpose, in order to accomplish the destination, what the soul actually wants. So if we come to know regarding that, just you can imagine that how happy we will become in our life. It may happen that we may have got nothing, still we are happy. We may feel that God has given us everything in order to fulfill our life. That can be understood from the D9 chart, not from the D1 chart. That is the reason when we talk about Navamsa chart, the first thing which comes in our mind is marriage, spouse, marital happiness. Now you can think that why is it the soul purpose of life and why it is marriage? Because when we have a relationship with a spouse, or when we come into the duty of marriage, the responsibility of marriage, we expect that our spiritual awakeness and the spiritual awakeness of the spouse should be at the same spiritual level. The soul should understand the other soul. If the soul does not understand the other soul, the marital bliss and the marital happiness won't stay for long. That is the important, that when we match the horoscope, it is very essential to understand that we should also check the Navamsa chart for the marriage, for the marital bliss. There is a misconception that when we talk about the Navamsa D9 chart, we say Navamsa chart is for the spouse. No. Navamsa chart is for us. It is the soul, what the soul actually wants. Marriage is just one of the important parts which can be understood from the Navamsa. Out of many other facts, this is one of the fact. This is not the overall. And this tool is a very powerful one, the D9 chart. It is so powerful that we can actually understand the marital happiness, the marital discord, everything. The nature and the behavior of the spouse, how the spouse will look, the work, what the spouse will be doing, everything can be understood from the Navamsa chart. That is the reason. The significance of the Navamsa is the planet Venus. Venus also significates marriage, Venus also significates relationships. Venus is also the significator of the spouse. Basically, Venus is the wife for the husband. So you can understand that how powerful the Navamsa chart is. So if we don't read and if we don't judge the D9 chart along with the D1 chart, we are actually making a blunder. Now, what about the lagna, what about the seventh lord, what about the placement of Venus? Let us talk about that first, because how we can read the Navamsa chart, that is very important. Now suppose you are Cancer ascendant, so we will check the placement of moon because it is the lord of the sign Cancer in the D1 chart. We will also check the placement of moon in the D9 chart. We will see how the lagna lord is performing in the D9 chart. We will check the dignity of moon. The true dignity of the planet can only be understood from the D9 chart, not from the D1 chart. So we have to check the dignity of the planet moon in the D9 chart. Then only we can understand that how the flow of water actually goes. Is there many obstructions in order to fulfillment what the soul actually wants, or there are many obstacles? That we have to understand the placement of the lagna lord. Now the placement of sun, the placement of moon, because moon is the mind, sun is the universal significator of the soul, that should also be understood through the placement of the Navamsa. That also will give hint that what actually we want from our life. Secondly, the lagna lord of the Navamsa chart, the seventh lord of the Navamsa chart, because when you are talking about the marriage, that is also very important. And when we are talking about the overall aspect of life, then the lagna lord of the Navamsa chart, where it is present, because it is ruling the Navamsa chart, it is the lagna lord of the Navamsa chart, that is also very important, the placement of that. Now when you talk about the Gemini astrology, there are Charakarakas, the Chara significators, what we call, that is the Chara Atmakaraka or the Chara Amatyakaraka, the planet which holds the highest degree in your D1 chart is termed as Atmakaraka, the Atmakarak planet for your life, in this lifespan. It may be Venus, it may be Saturn, I am not talking about Sun. Sun is the universal soul significator. But in this life, your soul significator can be any planet. It can be Mars, it can be Mercury. The planet with the highest degree, for example, out of the all the planets, I am not talking about Rahu and Ketu. I am talking about Sun, Moon, Mercury, Mars, Jupiter, Venus and Saturn. Out of these seven planets, the planet with the highest degree. Now suppose it may happen that your Jupiter is at 28 degree, then we will call Jupiter as your Atmakarak. The placement of Atmakarak in your D9 chart is very important. In fact, I will say it is the most important part. Because soul, when we are talking about the soul, D9 is the soul of the horoscope. And Atmakarak planet, the Jupiter here, for example, it is at 28 degree highest, suppose. And suppose Jupiter is in a very good dignity in the D9 chart. Suppose it is in the Lagna. Suppose it is in the Sagittarius sign, Sagittarius rising in the D9, and suppose Jupiter is sitting over there. So it is a very brilliant placement for Jupiter. So you can say that such person will have a purpose of life to gain wisdom, to gain through the Shastras, for the ancient scripture, because of the blessing of Jupiter. That can be understood from the D9 Navamsa chart. The second most important part after that, the Atmakaraka, is the Chara Amatyakaraka. Amatyakaraka is the planet which holds second highest degree out of all the seven planets. Now suppose Sun holds your 26 degree, which is the second highest. And suppose Sun sits in the 10th house of the D9 chart. So what happens? Sun gets directional strength in the D9 chart now. So here you can say the placement of the Atma Karaka and the Amartya Karaka becomes very crucial for the progress of your life, for what your soul actually wants. Because Amartya Karaka, Amartya means minister. It is basically the advisor, it is basically the helper who helps the soul, the significator of the soul, to utilize all the resources and accomplish the purpose of life in this lifespan. That's what the soul actually wants in this lifespan. That is the reason we are taking the birth. The journey of the soul is infinite. We never know that when we are getting the destination. We never know. Until and unless our devotion towards the Almighty is very pious, and until and unless we get the blessings from the Almighty, our journey of this soul will never stop. So the journey is infinite. We never know when it is going to end and when, up to how much it will go. So whenever we are taking the birth, this goes on. Now, the soul is present. Soul is always present. Soul cannot be destroyed. So when does the fructification of D9 actually starts? That is very important question now. I will say the D9 is present every time. Even when we are child, even when we are 60 years old, even when we are 25 years old, D9, the fructification of the D9 chart is always there. But since it is the actual goal of the soul, how are we going to know it? That is very important. For example, you will see that you might be under your parents, you might be under the jurisdiction of your family, or you might be in a work, you may be liking the work, you may be earning in millions, but still you have to listen to your boss every time. You wanted to start your own venture, but you are unable to do it right now. But when you are getting the maturity, when you are getting the information from the world, when you are going through the obstructions, now your soul is getting the maturity now in this body, and your soul is directing you to go towards that accomplishment of the purpose of this life. So what happens? A huge amount of lifespan is already passed to gain that maturity, to gain that power and strength to accomplish it. That is the reason we say the fructification of the D9 chart actually takes place in the second half of your life. That means maybe after 35 or 36 years. But if you are matured enough, if you are following the true wills of your soul, and if you really get the support from your environment, then you can fructify the D9 chart even in your childhood also. Because now you are following what your soul actually wants from you. Otherwise, what will happen? That you will come back from your job at your home and you will speak that, yes, I wanted to become an athlete or I wanted to become a painter, and after 5 or 10 years, suddenly you start painting. The world may feel that, oh, he has the best of his life. See, he has the best education, he has the best wife, he has the best job, he is earning in millions, and see, after coming from office, he is following his wills, he is following his hobbies, he is painting. And ask him, he will say that when he is painting, he is much more happy than earning millions. Because his soul wants that. And you will see specific placement in the D9 chart, which is not present in the D1 chart, which is actually helping him to do that painting, which he has thought of but never couldn't do. He couldn't do up to this much year has passed. But now he is doing. He is following his wills. He is following his wishes. He also don't know that where that wishes comes from, because that is the hidden agenda of the soul. That can be understood only by the D9 chart, not from the D1 chart. So these are the important facts which we understand from the D9 chart and not from the D1 chart. So next time when we go for any analysis of any horoscope, please also take into account the D9 chart. Follow what your soul actually wants, because it is the duty, it is a responsibility which we have to follow in this life. That actually what we get to know from the D9, not from the D1. Because 9th house is the house of Dharma, 9th house is the house of actual higher belief system, philosophy, duty, responsibility. That is the Dharma. Dharma here does not mean the religion. Dharma is actually what you are, the purpose of life, the basis, the foundation why we are here. Many a times we see the planets are in a very good dignity. We see that Sun is in the sign of Aries in the D1, and at the same time we see Sun is in the sign of Aries in D9 also. Whenever a planet is in the same sign in D1 and D9, we call it Bhargottam. Means Uttam means best, Varg means divisions. Means out of the divisional charts, it is the best placement. Similarly, suppose a planet is debilitated in the D1 and debilitated in the D9 also, so we will also call it Bhargottam. Suppose Moon in Scorpio in D1, Moon in Scorpio in D9 also, so it is Bhargottam, but debilitated Bhargottam. So here what happens, the dignity of the planets becomes much more low. It has not improved, rather it has got debilitated in the D9 also, means the dignity has worsened. So in that particular case, the ability to do good will suffer, will be very difficult. So Bhargottam does not always means that it will give the best result. We have to see the dignity of the planets, how it is becoming Bhargottam. So everything should be taken into account when we discuss regarding the Navamsa chart. Basically, we have to understand that what we actually want from ourselves. That is the reason always I say that the churning of mind is very essential. Many a times you will see that we are not getting the answers from ourselves. Why don't you meditate? Why don't you take a few minutes for yourself? Just close your eyes and try to listen what your antaratma, the inner soul, wants from you. You will get the answer. That is what the D9 chart is all about. Because next time when you go to an astrologer, before the astrologer speaks, you will speak that, is it this? That is the beauty of astrology. That is the beauty of divisional charts. And why the Vedic astrology is so successful. So next time when I come back, I will be coming back with a new video. And if you really like this video, share this video with your near and dear ones. Like this video. And if you are new to my channel, press the subscribe button, press the notification bell icon, so that every time I make a new video regarding this, you get notified instantly. And if you have any query, you can type it in the comment box. And if you want any consultation regarding the analysis and judgment of your D9 and D1 chart, type into the links below. You will get the link so that you can get the consultation, the right consultation from me. For the next time, I will be coming back with a new video. Till then, stay safe, be careful, take care of your health and your mind also and your soul also. Meditate. I will ask for your meditation and for all the spiritual practices, because spiritual practices will help you to go ahead and understand your soul more nicely. Till then, thank you. I'm signing off. Bye bye.